All right, boy. It felt like we just played, you know what I'm saying? Because we did, you know? But we're back. Pre-game, week 16, Washington, Dallas, round 2. So without further ado, let's get straight into today's video. But before you do, make sure you guys go down below, leave a like on this video, subscribe if you're new, and turn on post notifications so you get notified when I upload a video about the NFL. Or in this case, I watch the football team. Let's get straight into today's video. So Washington, Dallas, round 2. And what can I say? I still won Dallas. I don't care. Yes, I understand. We lost. Things isn't looking good right now. But I'm going to stand up here and stand on all 10 until, yes, I still won Dallas. You know what I'm saying? I ain't hiding. I can't hide. I already put my face out there. So it ain't no hiding. So I'm just going to, you know, say I won Dallas because I really do. But before we even get into this game, we got some serious stuff to talk about here. Safety DeShazer Everett got into a car accident yesterday. Yesterday. He was the driver and the passenger was killed. So that's pretty, you know, sad and unfortunate. We see these cases all the time with players. And it sucks because, again, a life has been lost in this situation. And you never want to see that happen. Now, I know everyone is quick to make the Henry Ruggs comparison, but no report has been came out and said DeShazer Everett was under the influence. So I don't quite know if I would compare it to a Henry Ruggs situation. And it still sucks. It still sucks. Someone's life is still lost. So I think DeShazer Everett is still going to be held accountable because he was the driver, right? Now, again, we don't know what happened as far as who did what as far as the DeShazer Everett. Was he the one that got hit, or was he the one that hit someone or something? You know, so again, we don't know too much. All we know right now is that he got into an accident, serious injuries but non-life threatening, and a life has been lost. So prayers up for the DeShazer Everett and the family's daughter that was affected by this. And I pray that you guys, you know, handle this situation, you know, and get a control of it, because again, it's sad, and my hearts are with you guys, because again, it's not easy losing someone, especially in the way that they lost their child. So again, prayers up for DeShazer Everett and everyone that was involved in this whole situation. As you guys know, I'll keep you posted on anything else regarding this situation as everything starts to unfold. Now, switching gears, let's get into this game. So Washington set to travel to Dallas on Christmas, obviously, and they play on Sunday. And I know everyone is just assuming that this game is going to be one-sided. I mean, we're 10.5 underdogs, according to the betting odds in this game. So obviously, we're the underdogs in this whole situation. You know, Dallas is riding high because not only are they coming off a win versus the Giants, they did clinch a playoff berth. So they are riding high. They still have everything in front of them. So I don't expect them to lighten up because they think they can get the one seed, right? They don't just want to win the NFC East. Like, let's be real. I mean, and technically the NFC East isn't over, but come on now. Like, Dallas is winning this division. You might as well give them the NFC crown and heads now, right? You know, they have everything in front of them, I should say, as far as trying to get the one seed. They really think they can do that. So they're going to be playing their hearts out just like how I expect us to. Now, we're going to be getting some players back that we didn't have in the game versus the Philadelphia Eagles. The most important one being Taylor Heinicke. Cameron Curl also is coming back too, so, and Kendall Fuller. So we're getting some reinforcements back from the COVID list, so that helps a bunch. I don't think Dallas is going to dominate this game as much as they did the first week. I mean, the first round. I mean, I understand Dallas fans are going to come on this channel and come on my page and try to say, excuse me, that we're not ready for Micah Parsons round 2, blah, blah, blah. I'm going to go on a record and say Micah Parsons doesn't dominate the way he did the first game. You got to think, guys, Dallas fans, be unbiased here. You know what I'm saying? We're seeing you guys in a two-week span. It's different if Micah Parsons dominated us in week 3 and now we're playing you guys again. Micah Parsons dominated the first match and we're seeing you guys 2 weeks later. You don't think we're going to, you know, try to stop that guy even more now, you know? So I don't think that defense dominates as much as it did the first round. And if they do, then shoot, hats off to the Cowboys, man. They really whipped us. But I just don't see that happening. I feel like we're going to come in better prepared. I think we're going to come in, you know, with a better game plan to stop that defense, to attack that secondary. Because first matchup, Terry McLaurin literally did nothing. I mean, it was times where he was open and the quarterback just couldn't give him the ball. I think we're gonna come in here better prepared. Curtis Samuel really didn't, he didn't play in that game for real. Like he wasn't involved in the game. I mean, all we did was use him in motion. He didn't play last week versus the Eagles. He was out. He's questionable. We'll get to injury report a little bit later, but I think we're going to find a way to get more guys involved. Again, I'm tired of just using Curtis Samuel as a motion guy. Like, again, he played versus Dallas, but he didn't play. You know what I'm saying? So again, I'm not saying we're winning this game by any means. But I do think we're going to come in this jump better prepared. I don't think that their defense is going to dominate how they did the first match. You guys caught us off guard. Y'all came in the fight swinging. Y'all came in the fight, instantly hit us with a right overhand. You know what I'm saying? And now I think round two is getting ready to start. You know, Ron Rivera is in our corner telling us what we need to do, you know. So I think this game is going to be closer than what many think. I think this game is going to be better for us as far as being more prepared now, because now we know what to somewhat expect. So I don't think this game is going to get out of hand how some may think. Now let's get to the injury report. Dallas is relatively coming to this game healthy. Now they're going to have a guy, whether he's compromised or not, he's still a threat. They're going to have a guy that they didn't have our first matchup, and that is Tony Pollard. And I'm pretty scared about that, because again, I think that is their best running back as far as being able to do it all. You know, special teams, running back, catching out the backfield, lining up in a slot. I think he can do it all, and that scares me a lot. I mean, we couldn't find an answer for Amari Cooper first matchup. Now just imagine what possibly he could do now that he has another weapon in Tony Pollard back to take, you know, put more eyes on him and take some off of Amari Cooper. We never really have a CeeDee Lamb problem. We never have a Zeke problem. Michael Gallup did have a tough catch. So, again, that offense is really good. We know how good it is. They coming into this game to be healthy again. But the only injury, and it's a big injury, is Tyron Smith, their left tackle, will now be out more likely than not. He sustained the foot injury versus us, so we could take advantage of that. I think Montez Sweat needs to be lining up on that, on that right inside, normally Chase Young's position, right inside left tackle side instead of left tackle, right tackle side, left and right tackle side. We need to move Montez Sweat around. That's a guy that now we're going to have back that we didn't have in our first matchup, and you can clearly see the difference he makes. You know, the defense was playing better at one point without Montez Sweat and Chase Young. But again, you see how easily we've been missing a guy like him or Chase Young. Because although they haven't had the best season, that is what a defensive end looked like. That a defensive end, a pass rusher looked like. We didn't have anybody when those guys was out that was capable of winning one-on-ones. Montez Sweat instantly comes back and get a strip sack. You know what I'm saying? So, again, yeah, they weren't having the best seasons, but that is what a pass rusher looks like. That is what a guy, you can just say, go out there and win your battle and you know, go make a play. We didn't have that. You know, we had team collective, you know, efforts that led to our defense being really good, which is cool and which is fine, but we never had that one-on-one guy that could just go out there and whip the left tackle or right tackle's tail, right? Now we have that in Montez Sweat, so I think having him back is really going to be good for us, I think we can possibly make this game closer than some may expect. Again, this game is a Sunday night game, so we have a little bit of a rest, but it's still going to be a tough hill to climb. Now, before we get out of here and get into my keys to victory / prediction, let's go over the injury report. So, out for Sunday's game, Landon Collins, William Jackson, Daniel Wise, and DeShazer Everett. Obviously, DeShazer Everett with the situation. Questionable Antonio Gibson and Curtis Samuel. Note, Jamin Davis was not as practiced today for personal reasons. So, we got to keep an eye on Jamin Davis. I think he plays, but that is something a little concerning. Hopefully, everything is okay with Jamin Davis. Out for Sunday, Landon Collins, William Jackson. Those are the two big ones. Landon Collins, I knew he was going to be out. Again, these guys played on Tuesday. I didn't see any way they possibly played on Sunday. And again, you're going to see Landon Collins being a big, big miss this Sunday, because again, he created the turnover not only last week, not only did he have a scoop up last week on the Montez Sweat strip sack, but he had a pick in the game versus the Dallas Cowboys. You know what I'm saying? So we're going to be missing Landon Collins a lot, and we're going to see that the run game is going to suffer. The run defense is going to suffer, I should say. William Jackson being out again, that sucks. We need our number one corner. We already don't have Benjamin St. Juice, so who's going to be alongside Kendall Fuller? Probably going to still see some Danny Johnson and Corn Elder, and you know, possibly even Troy Akpi. So it's gonna be tough, right? It's gonna be tough. Daryl Roberts too. You know what I'm saying? But I think again we can make this game closer than much maybe people may think. Sorry about that. Now, questionable, Antonio Gibson and Curtis Samuel. Now, this is a surprise to me because Antonio Gibson, they said he suffered an injury similar to last year. Turf toe, just not as quite as severe. Again, I don't know if that's the case, because if that was the case, I think he doesn't play. I don't think it's a chance that he plays if he suffered the injury, same injury that he did last year. Now, it is a toe injury, but again, I don't think it's as severe because, again, he had a turf toe last year, and he was instantly out for the next game. And considering the fact that we played on a Tuesday and he's still questionable, I don't know if it's that severe. Now again, we'll see Sunday. It's still 2 days to kick off, so it can easily flare up, but again, I don't think it's that serious compared to the turf toe last year, because again, he would probably already be out. And Curtis Samuel, hamstring, I think he plays. Now I could be, you know, wrong, and it tightens up on him on Sunday, you know, doing warm-ups. Hopefully I'm wrong, knock on some wood here. But again, I think Curtis Samuel plays, and again, we gotta find a way to give him the ball, because every time we see him play and we be like, and he's getting ready to play, we be like, okay, I think they're gonna use him more, they're gonna give him the ball more, and they never do. So I think Scott Turner needs to find a way to really, really get Curtis Samuel going. Give him some touches in the backfield. You see what Deebo Samuel is doing for the 49ers, man. And I hate to make comparisons, but it sucks watching these guys do that and then be like, we have that. We have these kind of players that can do that, and we just never do it. And that's all on the play calling by Scott Turner. So there you have it, man. That is the injury report. Now let's quickly get to my keys to victory. It's not a lot of keys to victory, because again, we're the underdogs, and the people are not a lot expecting a lot. So all I say is contain that pass rush. Get after Dak Prescott. I remember first game he was flustered. You know, for some parts of the game, Cole Holcomb interception. We're getting some pressure on him. He just looked off, right? So continue to make him do that. Get you know, contain that pass rush and get a running game going. Get Terry McLaurin the ball early and often, whether it's a jet sweep, a handoff, a quick slant, something quick to get Terry involved, because we cannot have Terry not having no catches in a game. That's terrible. Two targets he had in that game, 2-3 targets, and one he got hurt on. Like, we can't have that. It's no way your best receiver on your team and a top 15 in the league should be going a game without having a reception. That's just ridiculous. So we need to find a way to do that, and I think Washington could somehow find a way to win. But here it is. This is my key. This is my prediction. Washington, Dallas, who do I have winning? Although, I think we're going to keep it close. I think it's going to be a closer game than some may think. I just don't think we have enough, man. I just think Dallas is rolling. They're trying to fight for that number one seed. They don't want to have any slip-ups. You know what I'm saying? And again, I just don't think we have enough. We're coming off two losses, coming off of a very, very short week. We're still getting players back. Players are trying to get the win back under them, you know, with the COVID being out for a week. I just don't think we have enough, man. And again, we got banged up and COVID hit us at the wrong time. So I think this is where Dallas puts a bow, an arrow in our season, no pun intended. You know, and I think we just start preparing for the offseason, man, because, again, hopefully I'm wrong, but I just don't see it where Washington could somehow upset Dallas. So, yeah, man, there you have it. As always, me and my guy, like, comment, subscribe, host to the Washington football team. Make sure you guys are here at 8:10 p.m. for Sunday's kickoff, you know, where I start the stream. See you guys there. As always, me and my guy, I'm out. Peace. Cross me one time, that's gonna get you pop. Get you pop.